Hey guys, welcome back. In this video, I'm gonna tell you how you can use your past to actually leverage your future. Stay tuned. Hey guys, Steven Scoggins again, Journey Principles Institute. If this is your first time here, we give you life mastery strategies that work so you can actually get on with your future and make the most of your life. So today's feature conversation is how your origin story, in other words, your past, where you came from, how you grew up, etc., helps you leverage your future and moving forward. And one of the best ways I know to help you identify what that looks like is the young boy with a big, big heart, right, from the movies, named Anakin Skywalker. Now, Anakin Skywalker was a Jedi in the making. He was taken and mentored by Qui-Gon Jinn and all this other movie terminology that some of you may know and some of you may not. But what you need to know about Anakin is, unfortunately, through a turn of events, Anakin became Darth Vader, one of the most evil of all the Sith Lords, if you will, in the movies. At the same time, he also became back to becoming one of the best Jedis that ever happened. His origin story, how do you take someone's beginning and how does that shape their present? And then how do you take all the information from there and actually help it shape your future? You need to have a better understanding of what you're actually doing and what you're using so you can understand how to leverage everything you've learned to date, get rid of the bad, and take over the good, right? So let's go ahead and break down what an origin story looks like, and I hope it'll help you begin to break down where you're at today and how you got there and then what to do next. All right, so here we go. At the top of everything we have is called the influences. Right? There's several types of influences that actually make a difference in your life today. You have the parental influence. When I say parental influence, I mean people that acted as parents. They may or may not have been parents, for example. My particular parental influences were actually mentors. A lot of my parents, unfortunately, were gone for a good chunk of my life, off and on. So I had to rely on surrogate parents of sorts. And their influence and the way in which they taught me and trained me was actually one of the most important things in my overall development to make sure that I did not repeat my parents' negative behavior systems, right? So, parental influence is another one, or is one specifically. How about your overall relationships? The people, the family members, the friendships you had along the way, that's an influence. Subliminal influences, right? These are the things, the music you listen to, the movies you watch, the things that you do that kind of program your eye and your ear, so to speak, right? All of these are influences here that need to be looked at because they're either taking you down or they're taking you up. So can you take information from those influences and actually separate the good from the bad to make sure that you're actually getting some traction? I'd like you to think about your influences and think about the things that maybe you wish you hadn't been part of your influences. See if there's something you can learn from there and then go ahead and jot that down and then remove the rest. Just toss it in the garbage, right? The next thing is the environment, right? I used the movie reference of Anakin Skywalker. Well, he grew up in a desert with nobody around and then all of a sudden went out to the stars on big battleships and starships and stuff, okay? Your environment makes a place for your actual prosperity or your lack of it, okay? So if you grew up in a tough environment like I did, low poverty income, that kind of deal, then you're gonna have a predisposition to a certain level of behavior systems that come from your origin stories. For example, the poverty mindset was huge for me. It took me forever to actually being okay with actually becoming successful. Now, when I first started that journey from the poverty mindset, I wouldn't have thought that I would actually have to be okay with being successful until I started becoming successful, and then I wanted to hide everything that I was doing from everybody else around me so I didn't offend them, okay? Same kind of concept. An environment can actually shape how you see yourself and how you see the world, right? So is that going well or going poor? And what kind of roadblock, like for me with a poverty set, does that actually use to actually either hold you back or propel you forward? What are the top three things that from a negative standpoint from your environment that you want to remove? And what are the top three things that you can use to catapult yourself towards the future? All right, next thing. Your experiences, right? One of the key things that turned Anakin Skywalker into Darth Vader was the death of his fiance. Well, actually, I guess in the movies it was his wife, right? He lost his wife and he went on a killing spree because of all the pain and loss and stuff like that. That was an experiential thing that began to shape who he became. What types of things have shaped who you've become? Are those things positive or are they negative? How can you take the negative and actually learn from it and flip it around into a redemption phase, if you will, and actually make it to a positive, right? One of the experiences that I had to overcome, unfortunately, was the lack of abandonment, right? And again, for those of you guys who are new, dyslexic, so I'm gonna misspell stuff, right? All right, so abandon. I had to struggle for a long, long time, almost three decades I spent chasing the abandonment feelings and not wanting people that I love to run away and always self-sabotaging and making that a reality for a long, long time, right? What kind of experiences do you have and what anchor can you actually make that to? Okay, so if I say an anchor, a lot of people don't really think about what that could be, right? An anchor for me was the abandonment piece, right? What do you have, all right? Next things, how did each of these begin to shape my overall belief system and values? I already mentioned a couple different beliefs that I had. One, that I deserved to be poor, right? That I deserved not to have any kind of wealth, or I deserved not have any kind of success, right? So I had to come over with the poverty side. I had to come over with the fear of failure. Oops, and I'm gonna jack that up, right? The fear of failure and the fear of success, right? Talk about walking a tightrope and making you feel like you're bipolar, right? One minute you're grinding and hustling and the next minute you're like, what am I doing? I don't deserve all this, right? All of these are examples of limiting beliefs that all started getting shaped back here, right? You want to make sure that you can take the good, keep it, learn from it, leverage it, catapult it, move you forward, and get rid of the garbage. All the pain, all the hurt, all the junk, all the various things that you saw as a dramatic experience. It may not have had to be a really big thing, right? But if it was a traumatic experience for you or a painful experience for you, that's exactly what it was, right? So learn from that, okay? How did that belief system, right? So all of these areas here, this belief system, shaped my choices. It shaped my overall choices. It made me act in a specific way. I already mentioned self-sabotage, right? I began to self-sabotage because I thought that I wasn't worthy and I thought that my fear of failure and all this kind of stuff was who I was designed to be. Not realizing that that's actually what we call the lies that we believe, right? So if you want to overcome any specific area of your life, you got to actually identify the lies that you've been telling yourself that have been controlling your overall limiting beliefs. For me, poverty, right? Worthy issues. I'm not worthy, right? The other, poverty worthy, and then the other one was abandonment, right? In other words, everybody's gonna leave. You see how I did that? All I did was I pulled that from my experiences, right? Which then dictated my choices, right? Once I identified this and I removed this, all of a sudden I stopped doing things that self-sabotage to hold me back. And you can too. We all have a certain amount of blind spots and struggles that we struggle with, okay? This is the way in which you actually identify that stuff. Remember the recognized roadblocks from the grow process from the other video? And if you haven't watched that, you really need to, right? Remember that? That's how that choice is shaped, which then dictates the results, okay? So what I wanna do is I wanna take the lessons that I learned. In other words, I am worthy. I can be successful, okay? I can live my best life now. I don't have to wait, because you only get one life, right? Make the most of it. Don't sit on your hands. You can make a difference just by proving to yourself to take the action, because something interesting happens when you take action. It inspires other people to do the exact same thing. Your life can matter, and as it does, other people's lives will matter. All right, useful tools. A couple of things that I took away from my results specifically, and my choices were, one, I needed a mentor, right? That was a tool I needed. Three, I needed to identify my gifts and my talents and strengths. What are the things that come natural to me? I talk a lot about that because it's so important, right? The other thing that I needed to do is sharpen a skill set or create a new skill set. Being on camera right now for me to help you right now is a new skill set for me that I'm trying to grow in so I can be that much more effective in how I'm helping you, all right? Now, truth. Every lie needs a corresponding truth, OK? Okay? Every lie needs a corresponding truth. So whatever lie you discover and going back through your origin story will also need a corresponding truth. Okay? Again, you saw me do it already. I am worthy. I am worthy. I'm worthy to be here today because I've worked really, really hard. I've done the push-ups. I've studied the books. I've watched the videos. I've gotten the mentorship, right? I'm worthy to help you get to the same place because I've actually done it, right? And I want to do that for you because you're worth it, right? Gifts and successful. It's okay to be successful. And I know this seems a little bit redundant, but it's because these are the three most important lessons. Yours would be different, could be different, right? But it's okay, right? That's my truth. My truth is also that I want to transform a million lives. And you can actually help me do it. One, you can actually learn what I'm teaching you, apply it to your life, and transform your own life. Two, you can share this with a friend or someone that you think maybe could use the help, right? Both ways are in which we can work together, join the mission, and help transform lives, right? So go back, look at your overall origin story, identify both your positive and negative influences. Same thing with your environment. List out your experiences. Overall, look and see how that shaped your overall belief and value system. Look and see what you need to use and what you don't need to use to move you forward. Discover how you made choices and discover how you can make new choices with the information you learned over here, okay? You'll get new results, you'll get traction, and you'll finally become unstoppable. You got this. Stay at it. See you in the next video. That's about all the time we have for today's whiteboard lesson. Hopefully that gave you some real value that you begin to put away right now. If you enjoyed today's video and you want to dig even deeper, I put together a free ebook called The 5 Must-Have Principles for a Personal Breakthrough. If your goal is to make change in any area of your life, these 5 principles are absolutely necessary if you want to make that progress lasting. You can access that by clicking the link in the description below this video. All right, you're up.